Good morning students, welcome back to saradamathschannel. In this video I am explaining the most IPE 2 marks questions from the topic productofvectors Maths1A, and the students who will follow these videos this time will definitely attempt all the questions in the coming public examinations. So all of you once watch this video and check all the problems in these videos, okay? These are very helpful to you. Okay, let us start the class. The first problem: if A bar, B bar, C bar, D bar are vectors such that A cross B bar is equals to C bar cross D bar and A cross C is equal to B cross D, then show that the vectors A minus D and B minus C are parallel. So here four vectors are given, and also given that these two conditions, these two vectors are equal, these two vectors are equal. Now we have to show that these two vectors are parallel. Okay, that is the question. So first I write the given data here. So what are the given vectors here? Given that A bar, B bar, C bar, D bar are vectors. Four vectors are given. Given that A bar, B bar, C bar, D bar are vectors. Such that, what is the conditions given here? The first condition is A bar cross B bar is equal to C bar cross D bar. The first condition, A bar cross B bar is equal to C bar cross D bar. And the second condition, A bar cross C bar is equal to B bar cross D bar. Okay, these two conditions given. We have to show that these two vectors are parallel. So if the vectors A bar comma B bar are parallel, then what is the condition? If these two vectors are parallel, then A cross B is equal to 0. Okay, if the two vectors are parallel, then the condition is A cross B is equal to 0. Now we have to show that these two are parallel, means it is enough to show that the cross product of these two vectors equal to 0. Okay, if the cross product of these two vectors are equal to 0, then the two vectors will be parallel to each other. So first I take the here cross product of the two vectors. First vector cross second vector, A bar minus D bar cross B bar minus C bar. Okay, now multiplying the two vectors, here take the cross product of two vectors. First one, first vector cross second vector, that is A cross B. First vector cross second vector. Next, first vector cross last vector minus, this is A bar C bar minus A cross C. Okay, first vector into this one, first vector into this one. Now coming to this one, second vector cross this one, that is minus D cross B. First we have to take the D only, not B, since here we have the first vector as the D, minus D cross B, minus of minus, plus second one into second one, that is D cross C. Okay, and this is equals to, okay, so A cross B, the first vector is A cross B and the next vector is A cross C. Okay, just leave these two here, and this is nothing but plus B cross D, D cross B. Now just interchange these two values, then this becomes the plus value here. Okay, plus B cross D. Just I am interchanging the product here, then we get the minus, and minus of minus becomes plus here. And here this is minus C cross D. Here also I am interchanging these two vectors, then we get the minus sign. So minus C cross D, and this is equals to A cross B minus A bar cross C bar B cross D. Already here we have that the value of the B cross D is equal to A cross C. So this is plus A cross C minus C cross D. And here we have that the value of the C cross D is equal to A cross B. So substituting that value, this is A cross B. Now cut the values, sir. A cross B minus A cross B, A cross C minus A cross C. All the values are cancelled, so answer is equal to 0. Therefore, A bar minus D bar cross B bar minus C bar is equal to 0. That is, the cross product of these two vectors is equal to 0, means the two vectors are parallel to each other. Therefore, A bar minus D bar vector is parallel to the vector B bar minus C bar. That's all. This is the answer. The two vectors are parallel to each other. Okay. Okay, so the next problem: in triangle ABC, if BC bar is equal to A bar and CA bar is equal to B bar and AB bar is equal to C bar, then show that A cross B is equal to B cross C is equal to C cross C. Okay, so these three values are given. We have to show that A cross B is equal to B cross C is equal to C cross C. So given that, so first I am writing the given data here. Given that in triangle ABC, the values of BC bar is equals to BC is equal to A bar, CA is equal to B bar, and AB is equals to AB bar is equal to AB bar is equal to C bar. These three values are given. So we have to show that these three values are equal. Already we know that In a triangle ABC, the sum of the three sides is equal to 0. That is A bar plus B bar plus C bar is equal to 0. So A bar plus B bar plus C bar is equal to 0 means A bar plus B bar is equal to minus C bar. Now in the next step, I apply the cross C to this equation, that is A bar plus B bar cross C is equal to minus C bar cross C bar. Just I apply the value cross it to this equation, which implies now multiplying the two values here, the first vector A bar cross C bar plus second one B bar cross C bar is equal to, this becomes 0. Okay, C cross C is equal to 0. There is a direct formula, which implies the value of the B cross C is equals to writing this value to this side, that becomes minus A cross C. Okay, just writing this value to this side, which implies the value of the B cross C is equal to minus A cross C is nothing but C cross C. Okay, just reverse the two values, then this minus becomes the plus. C cross C is equal to minus A cross C. That's all. So this is the first answer. Okay. Again taking the equation A bar plus B bar plus C bar is equal to 0. Again taking the same one, which implies the value of the A cross A plus C is equal to minus B. Okay. So first I take the plus C, right? First, in the first step, I take that plus C to that side. Writing the plus C to that side, that becomes the minus C. But here I convert the plus B to that side. That is A plus C is equal to minus B bar. Which implies applying the cross B to this equation, which implies A bar plus C bar cross B is equal to minus B bar cross B bar. Okay. And this is equals to, so multiplying the values, this is A cross B plus C cross B. A cross B plus C cross B is equal to 0. This value is equal to 0, which implies A cross B is equals to C cross B. Writing this C cross B to that side, that becomes the minus C cross B, which implies A cross B is equal to minus C cross B. Minus C cross B is nothing but B cross A. Okay, just interchange these two values, then we get the minus. So here B cross A is equal to C cross A, A cross B is equal to B cross B. Therefore the conclusion, therefore the answer is equal to, from these two equations, A cross B is equal to B cross C is equal to C cross A. That's all. This is the answer. Okay. Understand all of you? Most important problem. Okay. See the next problem. Find the area of the parallelogram for which the vectors A bar is equal to 2i minus 3j and B bar is equal to 3i minus k, or the adjacent sides. Okay, so two sides are given here. The two sides are A bar and B bar. These are the adjacent sides of a parallelogram. Now we want the area of the parallelogram. So first we write the given vectors. Given that A bar is equals to 2i minus 3j and B bar is equal to 3 minus k. And what is the formula for the area of the parallelogram when the adjacent sides are given? The formula is modulus of A cross B. That is the only form. If the given vectors are the diagonals, then we have to take the 1 by 2 also before this formula. 1 by 2 into modulus of A cross B to the, that is the formula for the area of the parallelogram if A bar comma B bar are the diagonals of the parallelogram. But here given that these are the adjacent sides. Adjacent sides means the formula is only modulus of A cross B. That is, first to find the answer, first we have to find the A cross B value. Therefore A cross B is equals to, first in the first line we take that ijk, and here the A vector quotients which are 2 minus 3 0, and here the B vector quotients which are 3 0 minus 1. Okay, so I component, j component, k component, there is no j term here, so we take the 0 here, and this is equals to I into, take the cross product here, just leave these two, and 3 1 0 3 minus 0 minus j into minus 2 minus 0 plus k into 0 minus of minus plus 9, and this is equal to 3i minus of minus plus 2j plus 9k. So this is the value of the A cross B. Now what is the area of the parallelogram formula? Therefore area of the parallelogram is equal to, the formula is modulus of A cross B. For writing this formula you will get the 1 mark, so compulsory you have to write this one here. Area of the parallelogram is equal to mod A cross B. That is equals to modulus of this value, square root of 3 square is equal to 9, 2 square is equals to 4, 9 square is equals to 81. So the answer is equal to root 94. That's all. This is the answer. Understand all of you? I will continue the remaining sums in the next video.